Welcome to Elton J. Fernandez. We've reached the final leg of our little Indian bridal, great Indian wedding season. We do have Maya for the last time. not last forever and ever and ever, but for this time,
still
for this
sad
season. I've prepped her face again and sort of got the hair to the similar style that we did the last for the cocktail episode. Now we're going into the final wedding formal scene and the reception after look. I'm going to keep this very simple, and let's say that the cocktail was in the evening and now the wedding is in the night, you want a quick changeover. This is also going to work for you guys, so let's get on with it. Take any card gel pencil, and you want to just rub that way into the eye. What I'm doing is I'm connecting that to the winged liner, like so. Don't bother about being too neat, I'm going to smudge it out. You want to really layer that in there. See, even if it's leaking out of the eye, below the lashes, that's fine. I'm going to smudge it. This will really enhance that almondy sort of shape. What I forgot to mention the last time was we put in some dark brown lenses just for fun, you know, we're keeping it young and experimental. Which is why the coal around the eyes will look that much more striking because we've got deep in the eye there. Now what I'm going to do is take a nice deep rich burgundy, sort of dark plummy burgundy. You can take any really, you can take a bottle green, a dark maroon, dark blue. I'm taking a dark plummy red, I'm taking a smudger brush and just rubbing that all along the lower lash line and the underside of this liner. So really softening the line there. And don't worry about this looking like it's going to be like you're soft in the eye, it won't. It's really going to look really like it's been smoked out, very sensual and beautiful. Very exotic. See, just take long strokes. Don't be afraid of going for this here. Look at that, so beautiful. The next thing I'm going to do is take a rounded brush like this. Again, take the same plummy color, just so we have some sort of continuation. And I'm going to literally ask my look right like that down. And just take this from the end of the wing up towards the socket there. Just blending that line into the crease. So picking from the end of the wing and then going all the way in the crease across and back and forth. I'm also going to take another cleaner rounded brush. I'm going to pick like a nice soft brown or a beigey sort of soft brown. I'm going to put this in the inner corners of the eyes right here and create a little rounded surface right there. So we're adding some depth there. Really bring the eyes tighter together. Now I'm going to add some dramatic lashes to this look. You want that full sort of sexy eye. Full set of lashes. Bring all out. Bring home the drama. While that dries, I'm going to keep the mouth nude. I'm going to add maybe a bindi. Now, all I have are the red bindis. I know in some parts of India it's considered, only married women can wear red bindis. Okay, I'm going to take a bindi. It is a red bindi. Very excited, right? Yeah. I'm going to take a blue pencil. You make this green, whatever. And you don't make these big bindis in these colors. Lovely blues. That a bit. You can take any blue. Now I'm taking a light blue, whatever, just keep playing with it. See, I'm rubbing on it so the cream is really disappearing. And then take a tweezer, just sort of get it in my hand. Let's place that beautiful blue. I'm going to put another coat of mascara just to marry her own lashes with the falsies. So we're really going daisy, but we're going very, very, it's still very elegant. And it's young and fun and experimental with the blue bindi and everything. Also taking a brown mascara, I'm going to go over the brows with this. Keep it really simple, really keeping the focus on this part of the face. It's really beautiful and the rest is just plain. So just push those brows upwards, filling in the gaps with some brown mascara, softening it as it were. Never use black in the brows, unless you're really deep skinned. But even then, I'd suggest a brown, a dark brown, like so. You see, you're a little girl at the other events, you're really just playing it down, you're keeping it fun, and then you suddenly appear out of your room like this. And the last thing I'm going to do is take some of this highlighter, any highlighter again, this is a bronzy sort of highlighter, and I'm going to just layer that on my cheekbones, smile, and use it as a blush as well, maybe. Yeah, it's quite nice. A little bit on the bridge of the nose. What about on the mouth? Let's just go for it. Oh, that's nice. So it's a matte texture, but it still has some shine and dimension. It's quite lovely. Now with the hair, what I'd suggest is, this is still the pony that you had for the cocktail. So just take some hairspray like that. Just gonna back comb a little bit of the hair so it gets some stay. Making a bit of a ghostla or a nest. So we'll do this, just spin one at a time. Taking some big pins, again unopened, putting it through the hair, looping it into the scalp, and then over directing it under like that. So you see that's one pin there. Now instead of letting it sag, I'm really going to give it a bit of a lift. And just push a few pins in there again. See, I'm bringing it through here, into the scalp, and then into the back. This I'll still see in the front. Now this hair, what we can do, literally just back comb it, so we don't want it looking too piecey and scraggly. I'm gonna take like a little bit of a shine cream or a smoothing cream, you can take any cream. Mind you, I'm not taking gel, this is cream, and I'm not using brushes or combs. I want a finger texture to keep it like home done and basic. So, and modern. Taking this cream, I'm just gonna run this with my fingers into the baby hair. Just to lose any frizz or all these flyaways that you might have had. And then just, you know, it gives a bit of a shine if you just run your fingers through here like that. I'm just bunching up some hair here, giving it some shape and direction. Just randomly. The last thing I'm going to do is take that highlighter and put it on her collarbones. See how beautiful that is? Right there. A little bit of the neck. Another decolletage. I'm going to add this gold chain. For those that like some jewelry, I'll cover it a bit there. There you have it. I think that's a beautiful formal look, very elegant, and this is the ultimate finale for the guest to the wedding. I think you'll just, I mean, we don't mean to take away the glory of the bride, but it will still be as striking and beautiful, young and playful and yet formal.
It's fun.
Yeah, it's fun and beautiful. Thank you guys so much for watching. Do write in and tell us how much you've loved Maya, as much as I have, hopefully, and how much you love me, and how much you love. And please subscribe to the channel and share with all your friends. This is the only way to get word out. Help us grow, and we'll help bring you more and more and more solutions and tutorials in the future. So stay tuned. We'll bring you something even more exciting next weekend. See ya.
See ya.
For the cocktail round. See ya. Cocktail finery, not.